The AEM21-9124 DS air intake system is engineered to add horsepower and reduce restriction compared to OEM air intakes, and it comes with a lifetime limited warranty. The AEM air intake utilizes a large reusable dry flow air filter. This oil-free filter is durable and very easy to clean. The AEM21-9124 DS air intake fits 2011 and 2012 Ford 250 Super Duty pickup models with 6.7-liter power stroke diesel engines. See the AEM catalog or AEMintakes.com for up-to-date model details. This air intake system is not legal for highway use in California or other states adopting California emission standards. Check AEMintakes.com for up-to-date information on emissions legality for specific parts on specific vehicles. AEM air intakes come with detailed instructions with pictures and diagrams. AEM intakes are engineered for specific vehicles to produce a safe horsepower increase. Make sure the vehicle is parked on a level surface. Set the parking brake. If the engine has run in the past 2 hours, let it cool down. Disconnect the negative battery terminal. Do not discard stock components after removal of the factory system. Loosen the hose clamp at the airbox neck. Unplug the MAF sensor and unclip the wire harness from the airbox. Remove the bolt securing the airbox in place. Disconnect the intake hose from the airbox neck. Remove the OEM airbox assembly by firmly lifting up and rocking it side to side to disengage the lower mounts. Remove the four screws attaching the grille. Unclip the plastic clip on the driver's side of the grille. Gently pull the top of the grille forward. Then, using a large flathead screwdriver, push down on the top of each of the five metal clips to release the bottom of the grille. Remove the grille. Remove four screws securing the headlight in place. Firmly pull out on the headlight and disconnect all three plugs. Disconnect the three wire harness clips and remove the two M8 bolts on the OEM airbox bracket. Remove the OEM airbox bracket. Disengage the two plastic clips at the top of the OEM airbox inlet duct. Disengage the plastic wire harness clip toward the bottom of the OEM inlet duct. Disengage the final plastic clip at the bottom of the OEM inlet duct and remove the duct. Measure and mark the OEM inlet duct as shown in the instruction sheet. Using a hacksaw or other suitable cutting tool, cut the OEM inlet duct on the line marked previously. After cutting the duct, remove the plastic clip. Remove one of the plastic clips from the top half of the OEM inlet duct to use during installation. Loosen both screws securing the coolant reservoir to the radiator. Firmly pull the coolant reservoir toward the front of the vehicle as far as it will go. While holding the reservoir in place, tighten both screws. When installing the intake system, do not completely tighten the hose clamps or mounting hardware until instructed to do so. Reinstall the lower half of the OEM inlet duct. Reinstall the OEM airbox bracket and route the wiring under the bracket. Install the 3-inch and a 9-inch edge trim piece on the heat shield. Trim the edge trim as needed. Install the heat shield using the clips from the OEM inlet duct. Install 24-inch and 6-inch edge trim around the AEM lower airbox inlet. Trim the edge trim as needed. Install the 9-inch edge trim on the lower side hole of the AEM lower airbox. Also, install the mounting bracket, part 32-3079, using the provided M6 bolts and washers. Install the two barbs, part 2-780, using the provided M6 bolts and washers. Install one barb on the inside of the lower airbox using one M6 bolt and washer. Install the lower portion of the AEM airbox and secure it with one M6 bolt. Ensure the MAF wire harness does not get stuck underneath the airbox. Place the O-ring in the groove of the AEM MAF adapter. Attach the MAF adapter to the AEM intake tube using the provided four M4 bolts. Install the OEM MAF sensor using two M4 bolts. Install the filter adapter by stretching it over the flared out end of the AEM tube. Drill a 1/4 inch diameter hole in the cap of the AEM air filter at the location of the dimple. Clean out all plastic shavings from the inside of the AEM air filter. Install the air filter bracket, part 32-3082, using two M6 bolts and washers. Also install the large and small grommets. Attach the AEM air filter to the intake tube using the provided number 80 hose clamp. Insert the 90-degree connector into the small grommet. Then attach the filter minder hose to the 90-degree connector. Install the intake assembly, ensuring the large grommet attached to the airbox bracket engages the barb on the inside of the AEM airbox. Plug in the MAF sensor. Align the AEM air filter and intake tube for best fitment, then tighten the hose clamps. Install the 10-inch edge trim on the side hole of the AEM airbox lid. Install the filter minder grommet into the AEM airbox lid. Feed the filter minder hose up through the grommet, then plug it into the filter minder. Once the hose is connected, press the filter minder down into the filter minder grommet. Install the airbox lid and secure it to the lower airbox using the provided 4 M6 bolts. Plug in all 3 headlight plugs and reinstall the headlight using the 4 screws removed in step 2J. Reinstall the grille using the 4 screws removed in step 2F. Position the inlet pipes for the best fitment. Be sure that the pipes or any other components do not contact any part of the vehicle. Tighten the rubber mount, all bolts, and hose clamps. Check for proper hood clearance. Readjust pipes if necessary and retighten them. Inspect the engine bay for any loose tools and check that all fasteners that were moved or removed are properly tightened. Reconnect the negative battery terminal and start the engine. Let the vehicle idle for 3 minutes. Perform a final inspection before driving the vehicle. It will be necessary to check AEM air intakes periodically for realignment, clearance, and tightening of all connections. Failure to follow the above instructions or proper maintenance may void warranty. Go to AEMintakes.com to find products, download installation instructions, view dyno charts showing estimated horsepower gains, and for other product details.